This shed rented for fucking 100 quid a month.
Oh, fuck.
No, didn't much of a fucking shed. No, like, he's six more of them in his buddy's place, and he'd probably six more of them, I don't know about. He's just.
Like that. All right.
So he'd have all the gear.
Right.
Well, he is the main for the
But he might be able to find secondhand stuff and that for kids.
This is my collection.
Oh, wow.
That's the Betson 140J. 34,000 original miles in it. As good as I've ever found one, to be honest.
What's the fascination, or why did you just. Why?
Why?
Yeah. Because there's always a story. That car means something to you for some reason.
Well, I was a bit of a DX crawler, man.
Yeah.
And just practically the same car. So I always wanted a Violet, like.
Right.
It's a Violet, like. So I found this one. Those two brand new genuine fucking front wings there. For, which is just a time warp of a fucking thing.
Isn't it just the brown velour?
Yeah. But it's glorious. Like the four light. She's a four light front with the four and one front. Like. I think it's fucking class, like.
That was the first car you had out drifting, was a DX, wasn't it? The grey colour, dark grey. Or black, wasn't it?
It was black, kind of. I had actually an FC RX7, it was the first car I had.
Go away,
yeah? Yeah,
A turbo or non-turbo?
Turbo 2, yeah. Freaking red jokes, always. This is one of my favourites. This is an Alpina B10 3.5.
7 series, is it?
5 series.
5 series.
Genuine article Alpina Sintner car from the UK. One of only 600 and something ever made. She's metallic black. That's why I have a 535 above her.
That's her spares.
Yeah, she's black lit interior. She's 5-speed manual, which is rare on her apparently. She's a 3.5. She's 260 brake, 160 mile an hour. It's more. It's a step on from the M5.
Wow.
And then she was the second feeder one to the bi-turbo. They did a bi-turbo version, which
the
is
Alpina,
an absolute fortune. But she's genuine metallic black. We'll try and step in there. Can we step into this?
Yeah, looking over there now. I see a familiar sight over there.
Yeah, there's a marvel history on that. That is a Black Limited Corolla.
Actually, I think I've seen you posting up about that. Yeah, those are super rare. Like.
That's genuine Black Limited from Japan. One of 400 ever made.
I think.
I absolutely stole that fucking thing too. Oh, lad.
You just don't have enough time for the amount of projects you want to get done.
That's a nice thing.
B10 3.6.
3.5.
Or
3.5. Yeah. Just the wheels with the fucking
centre range and all, you know. You don't see these things.
No. You can't get them if you want them. They're just worth the fortune. Oh, she's sitting there. That was 2 years ago. Is what more again? No. And this thing, of course, is the original.
This is the one that made your name.
Yep, that's the original car. I bought that when I was 16. My first road car, which I made to a drift car, and it's been all over the world.
It has been all over the world, yeah.
Yeah.
Can't get. Pity these things don't have zoom. The fucking little lefty sticker on it.
It's probably on this side, is it? As well.
No, but I like the plan with it, getting it up in the workshop, like.
Because, yeah, really, yeah, but I'm going to paint it purple again, like.
Are you going back to the old school,
yeah? It's going to go back to original.
Like. Yeah. And that it was in America with the SR, wasn't it?
Yeah. It never had nothing but an SR. Which...
Fucking mad. At the time, how an SR was able to do
look
it.
At that,
right? Oh, yeah.
2007 annual inspection.
That's what I was looking for.
Look, that's the ridge of it. McNamara Water Sales and Service. Look at the old 022 landlines. 86 Charlie Echo 1057. Famous ridge. We got arrested blowing in Chidani at the West Cocker Rally one day in the fucking thing. And we absolutely backwards broadside got all the fucking car park, myself and the buddies. And all you could see was this fucking, in the pitch dark, and all you could see was a fucking flashlight walking towards you, and a walkie-talkie going off, 86 Charlie Echo, 86 Charlie Echo, and it just fucking stuck.
Charlie
so the fucking, there was a number plate. When she went with the square back plate, there was a number plate with fucking Charlie Echo on it instead of the...
Oh, instead of CE.
Instead of the fucking...
Oh, man.
There was some laugh.
It's amazing how that car brought you so far. Like, for, you know, 16-year-old buying this little twin cam.
Yeah. That car, seriously, that car has paved the way for everybody.
It has. Yeah. It really has, yeah, and yeah, yeah. There's no doubt about it.
Global and
yeah.
The recognition and the fucking Irish drifting took it.
It blew it up.
Yeah.
It really did.
Yeah, like the flag, the fucking flapping flag off of it. Sure, people didn't even know. People thought I was in Mexico.
Episode 3 of No Grip Garages. I'm out here in Butevin in County Cork. I'm here with Darren McNamara. Some of you guys might recognise Darren, ex-Formula D driver, ex-pro drift driver, certainly has made his mark in the drifting world. Darren, came down here just to check out the garage, just to check out some of the projects you're working on. Give us a run through. You were in a smaller garage after moving here. What was the reason behind that move?
Well, we were actually here originally. In like 2 units up.
Okay.
And then we moved across with the whole recession and all that crap. Moved across to a smaller unit recession just next door.
Okay.
And then we're back again, back to square one. But these are obviously much bigger units.
Yeah.
And we've started on this, you know, it's a project, it's not finished, but you know, we have to get some work done on all these cars.
Well, something has to pay the rent. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
This is the like chassis and vehicle preparation side of it here. We're probably going to show you some other stuff.
Yeah.
It's a collection that I have of stuff that I've gathered over the years. This is where all the control arms are made. My own cars are built. There's an Audi Quattro there. You're using quite an expensive car as a camera stand.
Yeah.
Which
We have to use something.
You can see the camera. You wouldn't be happy with.
Yeah. But so you're working on a lot of projects in here. We have been looking at the D-Mac Onevia, or the D-Mac PS is going to be next year, you're telling
it's
me?
Going to be a PS,
So the chassis.
You're taking the Onevia.
I'm taking the Onevia, exactly, yeah. Certainly the chassis fabrication that you're doing up here is second to none, it's top notch. What kind of tooling are you using to do that? Is there any special tooling, or is it just years of experience? What way?
Yeah, I mean, actually, at Christmas time, we invested in a lot of stuff to be able to do the way I wanted it. So, brand new tube windows for making the cages, you know, we got a hydraulic punch and presses for doing all the swedging and bead rolling and the stuff, the straight panels and everything. So, this car will be kind of a showpiece to what we
do.
And you see there's a Corolla in the corner, that's another car that will be done that a customer wants done. And just trying to take it to the next level.
And that's, I suppose, a big thing is it's bringing up the level of the cars in Ireland. I suppose if we'd ever meet the level of the cars in FD, it would be fantastic. We might never get there. That money is probably not in this country. But it's great to see that the level of cars are certainly coming up. The Audi, we've had a look at the Audi. Mm-hmm. When can we expect that to see track? Can't wait.
Yeah, like this year definitely. If you asked me last month, I would have said April.
Okay.
I think that's got to move on to May now.
It's just been pushed out a little bit every day.
Like this thing and that. We just saw many cars to get done for round one. It's just unrealistic. I think that it would be a round one.
And is it going to be? Is it a demo car or is it a competition car you're building this?
Well, look, it is a demo car. It is a marketing car for the company, basically, and for all the companies that are part of it. Whether it'll be good for competition, we'll see when I drive it.
Yeah, well, there you go.
And see how much development it needs. I will do competition, definitely. Yeah. But we'll see. It'll take a while to develop. But it'll be for going to shows, but not like static shows, you know, going to
use the
motorsport festivals, good places like that. That's what it'll be for. It's supposed to be an impact car, most definitely.
It certainly, the first time I've seen it in Autosport, it certainly had that wow factor.
But we have 90% of the parts for it, it's right there, and it's a lot of it is together, and a lot of it is signed off on, and all the stuff is made, and on shelves behind us and everything. It's just to get the time and spend the time doing that and not making money.
It is that balance. You have to get the customer cars out there to keep the money flowing in, to be able to do that car.
Even this on the lift is an iron. So,
there you go.
We have to get it.
Look, that's what we're going to do now is we're going to have a look at some of maybe the customer cars that you have knocking around the place. I wouldn't mind seeing those. And thanks very much for your time. Thanks for having us down. Really appreciate it. Look out for the next one. Thanks for joining us. I'll talk to you soon.
See you.
Cheers. So.